this video, I'd like to give you some tips about getting the most out of the user interface in NovaMind 5. NovaMind 5 uses the Microsoft Fluent user interface concepts, but has some unique features to make it easier to use for mind mapping. One of the things you often want to do when you are mind mapping is to be able to see the absolute largest area of the mind map possible at a time. To facilitate this, we have translucent scroll bars that only become opaque when you mouse over them, and a sidebar that you can close so that it doesn't take up any room, and you can also double-click one of the tabs in the ribbon bar, and the ribbon bar will be hidden. But you'll still be able to use it by clicking on a tab and then selecting the item that you want, and then it will be hidden again. To show it again permanently, just double-click a tab. The ribbon bar tabs are broken up into command groups. At the bottom right of a number of the groups on the ribbon bar tabs, you'll see a small square icon. This is called a dialog box launcher and allows you to access advanced formatting options in a dialog box. If you're doing a lot of work using the options on the dialog, you might want to keep it open so you have it available as a floating formatting panel. The NovaMind menu is accessed by clicking the round NovaMind icon at the top left corner of the window and contains a lot of options for importing and exporting to different file formats. Just to the right of the NovaMind menu button are some handy shortcuts for saving files and undo and redo. Undo can also be accessed using Ctrl-Z and redo using Ctrl-Y. At the lower left corner of the window is a row of icons to access the different panels, like the Outline View and Topic Notes. If you have plugins installed which have sidebar panels associated with them, then they will be accessible on this bar too, and if they add ribbon bar tabs, they'll be available on the ribbon bar and so on. Also at the bottom right is the zoom slider and zoom amount selection, but you can also zoom in and out directly on the mind map if you have a scroll wheel on your mouse. Just hold the control key down while you use the mouse wheel to zoom in or out. This also has the advantage that the zooming will be centered around your mouse position. To pan the mind map, right-click and drag, or use the scroll bars.